you don't have to listen to my bio, and already you have figured out it was not born here. And so I have chosen to be here. And for that, I think it has value. Everyone in this room pretty much knows about SPLOST, and I certainly don't want to insult anyone's intelligence, but allow me to practice on you for the groups that I won't know. Let's remember, first of all, and look around in the last over 20 years of the number of wonderful things that we have, not only touchable things, but other things that SPLOST has brought to this community. I'm totally amazed, having lived so many other places where we need legitimate infrastructure things that could not be had, could only be patched, because they never planned this opportunity. Well, this is now the seventh SPLOST, and all of them, including this one, have been citizen-driven by community business leaders who have felt strongly about the fact that they, along with the support of Chamber every year, wanted to continue to be able to improve this community, particularly from an economic development perspective. We expect, if we can pass this, and I expect we will pass SPLOST 7, I can't lose anything, I can't tell you that, to generate $150 million within a six-year period. I believe that most of you have seen the brochures and the lists and the newspaper articles that have been through, the paper in the last few weeks, and so you're very familiar with those. So just a couple of things you might not know, and something I was pretty surprised at. Proceeds for SPLOST are divided very fairly and very equitably by population. So, if Lowndes County has 45.05% of the population, then they will receive 45.05% of the proceeds. And of course, that's true for Valdosta and that I remember to know many of the cities. I don't think it gets much fairer than that. And just about every major capital project that has taken place here in the last 20 years has all been involved with SPLOST spending. See, that becomes pretty expensive to say. Anyway, but governments can keep, our local governments can keep our property taxes lower as long as we have that to draw on, and we're not paying additional fees for property taxes. Also, many of the projects that we have on the list this year, I'm not here to debate the projects. I'm only here to encourage the continuation, not the continuation of our current SPLOST tax. But the projects, in many, many, many cases, are very, very necessary. And how can we pay for them without them? I don't think most of us on this end of the bank. SPLOST projects in the last few years, from an economic development perspective and private investment, have brought, through improved, significantly improved infrastructure, following companies, Walmart, Sam's, our conference center, the new Gander, Mountain Visitor, yeah. The Academy Schools, Convergers, of course, and Mountain's Pastries. We have an excess of 600 jobs that were created just from one of those companies. Had not the city and the county gone ahead with these programs and in advance put infrastructure in, made sure it was water and sewer, there were all these abilities to take care of fire issues and safety and so forth, they would never have spoken with us. And while I'm at that point, and while I speak of that, the quality of life issues, I know many, many people question, but I can tell you from serving on committees and interviewing businesses that potential candidates for our area, they want their families and their employees to be able to have things, new places to go. They want their children to be able to be influenced by good things. And so those things are really necessary. All in all, I would say to you that most all of the SPLOST proceeds are invested in this community, they're providing local jobs, and do remember, it's just a